Hey guys, it's Ace, Artsy Alcove here today. Okay, stop. And remember to like to be nice, subscribe to get in a giveaway, and comment to get in a giveaway. Thank you. Okay, what you're gonna need are puffballs, paint, and mason jars. Oh, and you'll need a paint palette of some sort. I'm using a plate. So, yeah. So, let's get on with the video. And just for a second, I'm going to show you what we're making. Here it is. So, yeah. Let's get started. So, I pre-mixed my paint. These are the colors that I'm using. I'm using this plate too. Anyways, let's get on with it. What you're going to need to do is take your jar, and I'm going to take this one because it's super cute. Love it. Okay, so take off the top first. Then you also need something to like put this down on. I had to find something real quick for that. Which I'm not seeing. Okay, I don't have one there, so I'm just gonna go back to get a tissue real quick.
I'm still here.
And I'm back. Okay, I'm using a tissue because I don't want to get a lot of paint on my desk. So, just before we get started, Alexa, what time is it?
The time is 5:07 p.m.
5:07. Okay, so. First, take one of your puffballs. You can also use like Q-tips and stuff, but I'm not gonna. I'm gonna take this purple, and then don't swipe, just dab like I'm doing. Like that. And you can make it as heavy as the coat as you want it, or as light. Okay, so I'm gonna go out again. And you can make this as thick of a line of the color. Don't make like a solid line where it starts and ends. Just kind of make them run together. At least that's what I want. Longest. Dabbing this along. Da, 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 da. Like, I'm in love with this purple, guys. Love this purple. I don't know if I'm gonna use the green or not. I'm gonna use this pretty far down because I love this color. Oh my gosh. Seriously, in love with this color right now. So again, it does not have to be perfect, and perfect is kind of like impossible on this one. Because like, if it's perfect, perfect would not be dotted. Perfect would be perfect strokes, no lines, all that stuff. And yeah. There's that incredibly cute purple. Oops. I'm gonna have to get this all over me because I have my sister's graduation tonight. So I have super cute nails. And those flowers. So, I normally do three colors, but I'm not a fan of my green. So, we're just gonna make it. We're just gonna add this to it instead. Because I think this is better than my green that I mixed up. Super bright one. So, Okay. Cover this. As you can see, I'm kind of just, purple ends about there, and my green's definitely running into it, but I want it. Kind of want it to be overlapped a bit. You could actually stroke it just to like get it started and puff the paint. That's sometimes what I do. Depends on where it is on the jar. Yeah, well, I have failed keeping my hands clean. Great. Love this. I honestly love it more when it's like that. Okay. I always try to do three colors. I feel like two is just not enough and four is way too much. So perfect balance. Yeah, it doesn't really work. Okay, let's continue with my last color. On my jar. Getting my nails super dirty. Okay. The front of it. I haven't done the back even. With my blue paint. Okay. There's that one. I'm actually just going to do another coat of my greenish, bluish, whatever color you want to call the middle one. Because, and some of these colors you might want to do like a thicker coat on because some of them. Or just, it's just not thick enough. Some of these colors are not thick enough for them to be finished in one coat. So yeah. There it is. I absolutely love it. Okay, I hope you guys loved this video. And I hope you guys have an amazing day. Bye.